If you want to do live webinars to build your audience online, to engage an online audience, and as a powerful marketing and selling tool, GoToWebinar has been around forever. It is perhaps the OG, the original player in the webinar space. Years ago, it seemed like basically any webinar you could find was hosted on GoToWebinar. And I myself have been a user of GoToWebinar for a long time, and I've done easily over 100 GoToWebinar events. But the question is, in 2019 and beyond, is it still relevant, especially now that so many other players are in the market? That's what I'm here to find out. Hello, I'm Shane Malach from activegrowth.com. And like I mentioned, I've been a GoToWebinar user for a long time, and I have personally experienced the powerful tool that is webinars. It really is an amazing marketing and sales tool. And there is one particular reason why I've been a GoToWebinar user for so long, and I'll get back to that in a moment. But right now, I'm on a mission to find out if GoToWebinar really is still relevant and if it is the best platform to use, or if one of the many competitors has overtaken it in terms of features, pricing, value, and so on. Over the next few weeks, I'll be testing every webinar platform and software I can get my hands on. I'll be reviewing them, and I'll do a big roundup comparison in the end. And I want to start with GoToWebinar, because like I said, it's been around forever. And let's get right into why it's been around for so long and what's good about it. The number one thing that I think made GoToWebinar as successful as it is just reliability and stability. You see, the last time I looked for alternatives to GoToWebinar, it's many years ago, I tried a few alternatives, and basically all of them had huge issues. They would crash, they would just freeze in the middle of stuff, they would just stop working, or they'd have like a 2-minute lag or something, or just the video or audio quality would be so bad that, you know, your chat or your questions in the webinar were just full of people saying, "This doesn't work, I can't hear you, I can't see you, what's going on?" And GoToWebinar was just the only platform where you could reliably do a webinar to 500 people, 700 people, 1,000 people even. And, you know, while it would slow down, there would be lag and so on, it would keep going, it would keep working. And of course, if you're using webinars as a marketing tool, if you're doing a sales webinar, that is just priceless. You just cannot afford to be doing a sales webinar to hundreds of people and then the thing just stops working. That isn't to say that GoToWebinar has a perfect track record. I've had occasionally issues with it as well. But again, out of, you know, hundreds of webinars done, it has basically almost never let me down, whereas there are several other platforms that I tried a single time and they just immediately failed. GoToWebinar also still covers all the basics that you'd want from a webinar, which means that it's not just for presenting. You can also do polls, interactive polls, where people can click on answers and then you can show the results, which is, I think, a great way to engage the audience and also to collect some insights about your audience. You can have surveys and handouts and people can ask questions and so on. So there's various ways to interact. Another thing I like about GoToWebinar is that you can use it for kind of group coaching. So you can unmute people and have them actually ask a question, you know, rather than just typing. And that's something that I think can add a lot of value to something like group coaching or even just a regular webinar where you're adding kind of more real, deeper interaction with your audience. So it has all of these basics. It has basically everything that you would expect from a webinar platform. GoToWebinar also has a pretty solid reporting and analytics tool. So it gives you good reports about like the attention and retention rates of your audience. It gives you a report of all the questions that were asked and so on. And I've found that often very useful, even after the webinar, just go through that data and learn a bit more about my audience. Now, having said that, there's also quite a lot that I dislike about GoToWebinar. So for example, it does feel a little ancient at times. Now, they've made various attempts at modernizing it, and especially recently, they really have modernized the UI, but it still feels lagging in some regards. So for one thing, you can do a web event, a webcast, or a regular webinar. The webcast is basically more convenient for your visitors. They don't need to download anything. They can just visit the webinar in the browser. The regular webinar, where people do have to download a thing and run an installer and so on before they can access your webinar, that does have some advantages though. So for example, the thing I mentioned before about being able to unmute someone in your audience and have a conversation with them, this is only possible using the regular webinar and not the webcast webinar. Also, the user interface, while you're hosting a webinar, while it takes a bit of getting used to, it's not the prettiest user interface. You know, it's functional. The questions feature and chat features are just not very great. So typically in GoToWebinar, I will end up with a huge list of questions from people, and it's very difficult to navigate. It's difficult to kind of pick out what should I answer. And you can't even copy and paste a question. So you can't like paste the important ones into a notepad, or you can't display the questions on screen. Really, the way the questions and answer thing works is just not very user-friendly. Another thing is that it's mainly made for audio and screen sharing. You can share your webcam as well, but it's a bit awkward basically. So in the live event, people will see the screen and your webcam at the same time if that's what you're sharing, but in the replay, the webcam will just not show up. And even if you record separately, so if you don't use the built-in recording feature, it's quite difficult to make that work with your webcam and screen sharing. Basically, I haven't found a satisfying way to do that and to make that work. Speaking of recordings and replays, there is an automatic recording feature, but after the webinar event, you have to convert the recording file from one format into another before it's usable. And the quality is not that great. It has gotten better. The audio tends to be a bit tinny and there's a delay and stuff. So it's generally better if you record your screen locally, you record your screen and audio while you're doing the presentation on the webinar, then you have a cleaner recording. But then if you have guest hosts and things, that makes things more complicated. So again, it's not terrible, but it's just not very convenient. So that's what I mean when I say that, yes, it has been modernized, but you can kind of feel the legacy of this thing. It feels like kind of an old piece of software in many ways. And finally, and this is one of the main reasons I've started looking at alternatives, the pricing of GoToWebinar is pretty steep. Like you have to pay $200 or more to get what I would consider like all the basic features, right? There's higher priced tiers which have additional features, which I think most people won't need. But you have to pay something like $200 a month before you get really, you know, all the stuff you'll probably want to use when you're doing webinars. That's a pretty steep price tag. And that puts me in a position where I feel like I can't really recommend this to the typical like startup entrepreneur, you know, trying to keep your budget under control. You're not going to just spend another $200 a month to do a couple of webinars. And this has me searching for better alternatives. In this video, I'm not going to go into greater detail about all the specific features in GoToWebinar. Like I said, it has its pros and cons, and I think that the cons clearly outweigh the pros, especially considering the price tag. And that's why I can't really recommend GoToWebinar. But I do want to be able to recommend something so that even if you are on a smaller budget, you can make use of the audience building and marketing power of live webinars. And so over the last weeks, and still as I'm recording this, I've been doing a lot of webinars on many different platforms, and I'll be releasing reviews of each of these platforms as I get them done. So stay tuned for more reviews of basically every GoToWebinar competitor that I can find. And if there's any one that you like in particular or that you're curious about that you think I should review, leave a comment below and let me know what it is. Also, if you have specific questions about webinar software or if there are specific features and things that you think I should look out for in my reviews, just leave your questions and comments below. All right, I look forward to hearing from you, and more webinar software reviews are coming soon.